Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Anthony Goodson, and you are watching rebrandUS alongside my co-host, Adrian, the Ace Stinson. What's up, Ace?
What's up, world? How y'all doing out there?
Same answer, say every time. What's up, Kim? How you doing?
Hey, everybody. I'm good. Healthy and living.
All right, so we got a great show tonight, y'all. We're going to be talking about traveling with a purpose. It's going to be a whole lot of fun. Some of you have been all over the world. We want to make sure that you guys tell us about your experiences on the world, over the world. And also, if you've had a travel agent, please give us some information about that too. We'd like to hear your experiences on that. Now, let me go ahead and tell you who our special guest is. To my left, y'all's right. Did I say that right? Am I looking the right direction? Oh, there you go.
Yeah.
Stefani Ivey. Now, the reason why we have Stefani on, she is not a travel agent. She just made that abundantly clear to us right before the show comes on. We actually have an agent that's going to come on here in a bit. But Stefani has traveled everywhere. Every time I'm on Facebook, Stefani is somewhere. So she got experiences that I think we can all learn from. So that's what we're going to talk about tonight. So I think it's time to just jump right on in. And before we do that, we're having technical difficulties with Joanne Guilford. She is a travel agent. She'll be on in just a little bit. Until we can get that straightened out, we're just going to sit here and have a conversation with Stefani for a little bit. So, Stefani, tell us a little bit more about your travels. Why do you do it so much?
I do it because I can. I don't have any kids. My job is pretty flexible. So I'm like, let me do it now while I can. Because I have friends who they've got the young kids and they can't really get out as much as they can. And they're like, you need to be doing that now. So that's why I do it as much as I do. It's because I can. And I know everybody else, a lot of people don't have that luxury. It's important to me to travel, though, because I believe, you know, we work hard, but we should not be living to work all day, every day, these long hours and just doing that day after day. We deserve a break. We work hard. We deserve to relax and unwind and disconnect. So I do it.
Hey, I love that answer. Ace, what you think about that answer? I love it.
Oh, yeah, I do too. It kind of puts in perspective. Got me mad. I'm calling in tomorrow. I say, yeah.
Use all of your PTO. Yeah.
Hey, want to say hello to Tasha Go Thomas. What's up, Tasha? We got Natasha Cummings. She said hello. Hey, Deborah Goodson. That's my mama, by the way.
Hey,
what's
mama.
Up, everybody?
Hey.
It's more than just a TV show. That's my actual real mama. Uh-huh. All right. So that's let's
my
jump
mama
into
too, by default.
Right on. We'll take it. All right. So I asked you why it's important to travel. Why do you like to travel? Relaxation? Are we talking tourism? Is it work a lot of times? Do you hit the beaches? Tell us a little bit more about that.
I don't like to travel for work. That defeats the entire purpose of my travels. So I go to, it just depends on what the trip. I go to relax. If I'm going to relax, then I'll go to the beach. If I need adventure, then I'll go skiing or camping. So it just really depends on what I'm in the mood for at the time.
Same here, you know. So we want everybody to kind of tell us their experience with travel, why they travel, what's the purpose of travel, is it work sometimes? But for me, I like to go to the same four or five places. I love going to New York City. That's an every year situation for me.
Okay.
Because when I was a kid, New York City was like the Mecca. I used to hear all these negative things about getting mugged and all that stuff. But if you can make it to New York City, you've made it. And the first time I went to New York, I came up out of 42nd and 7th, I believe. For those of you who don't know anything about New York City, that's Times Square. And that's right when you can see the big lights. And I fell in love at that very moment. I felt like I had made it, Stefani. So that's the reason why I travel to New York so often. We got people saying hello. Want to say hi to y'all. Hey, y'all. That must
What's
be
up, everybody?
Kayleen. Hey, Kaylee.
Hey, all right, so Kaylee.
I want to hear from all of y'all. Why do y'all travel? Kim, let's start with you.
I like to travel to have fun. I like to relax because, you know, it's the rat race. I'm just getting away from the rat race. I like to see different cultures, see how people are living on the other side of the map. I like to see how they relax. I like to see what they're doing, what they're wearing, how they're wearing their hair. Just you know, different things like that. So I like to see something different. You know, we come from a small town, and I didn't get to travel much whenever I was younger. So now, and my children are grown, you know, I'm just taking that. I am just taking that by the wings, and I'm just going for it. So that's what I travel for. I like to relax. I like to, you know, just enjoy the scenery, you know, and I like serene. I like to party a little bit, you know, but just a little bit of everything.
I used to work with a girl named Serene. She was Cuban. She used to like Mexican food.
Oh,
I don't know. All right, hey, look, we have Joanne in the building. What's up, Joanne? She finally got in. Listen, what's up? I want to say,
how are y'all? Got to some Wi-Fi.
Everybody on this show, on the top of, anyways, me, Stephanie, Kim, and then Joanne are all from Sulphur Springs. Even though I want to go ahead and say that, we quickly got out of Sulphur Springs. All of us rushed to your city.
I've only been gone for 6 years. So.
Six is a long time. Hold your breath for 6 years. So we all rushed out. Even Eric is from Carthage. He rushed out to come to your city, Ace. But Joanne, she decided to stop halfway. So she had bad internet connection. She's in a car. We're going to see how this works tonight. Hey, I want to get some quick shout-outs real quick to some of our listeners. We got Natasha Cummins. What's up, Natasha? Ama Weidman says, she said, it expands your mind to be exposed to the world. And then we have Kayleen, of course, and many, many more. I'll continue to say y'all's names throughout the night. Joanne, we're glad to have you on the show tonight. We were glad to have had
you. It was an honor and it was a pleasure.
It was a pleasure.
There it is.
Hey, real quick while we she's trying to get connected, shouts out to my boy Ivan Bushkoff. He's watching us from Germany. I told him I'd give him a shout out. Yes.
Why you got such a German name? That's what's funny.
He's from Germany. What you want?
Hey, coming up in a little bit, we have Rebrand Her. We got a special one for us. I think everybody's going to really appreciate who we have for Rebrand Her. All right, let me throw some more questions out there until Joanne get ready. How is it beneficial to have a, well, that's not a question that I should probably ask y'all. What's the, let me see. I got a few questions written here. I said, how important is it to you for you to travel? So Ace, I'm going to throw that out to you and Eric as well.
Okay. How important is it to travel? You know what? I'm actually a newcomer to the traveling thing. I never used to want to go anywhere doing a thing. But after my recent travel this past year, it is very important to travel. I went to Playa del Carmen, Mexico, and it blew my mind. I was amazed. I was impressed. I fell in love. I woke up early, you know, we were vacation relaxing. I woke up early every day because I didn't want to waste 1 second of the day. I wanted to embrace everything that Playa del Carmen had to give me. So I think it's very important, spiritual, you know, mentally, you know, all the above.
All right. So one of my mottos that I live by is, if what you see is all you see, then you don't see all that there is. And that's something I say probably about once a day, maybe. 2-3 times a week. But anyway, I'm telling somebody that all the time. And to me, that's what travel means. It means you get an opportunity to see different things, and then you get to experience a different experience, really. So Joanne,
does that motto come with a guy with a guitar wearing a diaper?
It comes with a preacher in the front named Tony Evans who told it to me. Okay. I don't know who else says it. Joanne, I think you are ready for us. All right, Eric, before we get to you, I'm going to go ahead and jump to Joanne. We have a few questions for you. First of all, we're talking traveling. Travel with a purpose. How is it beneficial to have a travel agent? And first, tell us a little bit about your travel agent, the name of it, and how people can contact you.
Hello, everybody. My name is Joanne Guilford, and I am the owner of JAG Vacations and Travel Agency. You can reach me at JAG Vacations, that's J-A-G Vacations at gmail.com, or you can go to my page of joannegilford.intellitravel.com. And just to kind of talk about travel and using an agent. Is that what you asked, Anthony?
Yes, ma'am.
I think in this day and time, it's just important to have like that advocate, because for me, I could just speak for myself and my business. I'm your advocate from the time that you want to contact me to do a quote request. all the way until you travel, until you step back foot in your door from your trip. I check everything, all your confirmations, keeping up with the different policies, vaccine entry requirements. It's just a whole lot of things that are behind the scenes because things are just changing daily. And that's what I'm here for. With my host agency, we're able to utilize resources to help you get not so much, and I don't like to say cheap, because what I think I provide is a value, because I'm your person and I want to be someone that you trust in this investment. I want to make sure that you have the best and most memorable vacation. So that's what I provide for my clients.
So I think a lot of people are going to wonder about money. Okay. So the first question people are going to say is it cheaper for me to get you, Joanne, to come and, you know, design my travel, or would it be better for me to just go on cheaptickets.com or Hotwire and do it myself?
Well, personally for me, I don't charge a consulting or researching fee. I know there are some fellow agents who do, and they can range from anywhere from $10 to $50 to $100, depending on how many quotes they provide, how many people are in your group. But I don't charge a fee. My fees are paid by the vendor, because of, some people may not know that the commissions are already built into the price. So that's where my services are paid for through the different vendors. And a lot of people don't know, when you go from, say, Expedia or Travelocity or Orbis, all those companies are owned by pretty much the same people. Expedia owns several, and Priceline Group owns several. So when you go to Cheap Tickets and Hotwire, it's all going back into the same pot. So you may be hopping from site to site, but it's still mainly going back to two main conglomerates.
So in a moment, Stephanie, I'm going to ask you, what's your top two places that you like to travel, okay? Your top two. In fact, I'm going to ask everybody, but first I'm going to ask Joanne. Joanne, why do you travel a lot yourself, and why do you like to travel?
I enjoy travel. I love to cruise. That's my favorite type of vacation. And of course, you know, cruising's taking a hit. And so I haven't had a chance to get back on cruises because I enjoyed going with my children. And now that they're in, also I'm a full-time, I work in a school system. So, you know, our days are, you know, I just can't take off a whole week or 2 weeks just like that. But now that, you know, children able to get vaccinated, I'm able to actually go on our first cruise, and we're going during spring break. So I'm happy to get back into that. But the other place I had a chance to travel this past summer was to Dubai. And people will hear Dubai and you would think it was, it is a beautiful city. It's an up and coming city. You think it's super expensive, but I was able to go on what's called a family trip for travel agents, which was a heavily discounted price. And we'd be able to tour, do all kinds of excursions. So just being able to take my children to the other side of the world, that was something that I've never thought would be possible. So I would say going to Dubai and New York so far has been a highlight for me. But I have many more places to go on my list.
How long is that flight? How long is that flight to Dubai?
We went on Emirates at a DFW, and it was 15 hours. No, 16 going and 15 coming back.
Were you just in that?
No, we actually, and they recommend you go at, we went at nighttime. So when we got over there, it was nighttime again. It was in the evening. So we left at like 8 p.m. And I would say, like, if you do that, Emirates or Qatar is some of the top airlines to take over there. They feed you. I mean, they really took care of us. And it was it's a very nice plane. They had all kinds of stuff. And it's a nice, if you're going to go that long, you know, they are also the ones who have the pods, which is a little bit out of our budget for four people. But, you know, you can get your own little pod if you have a, you know, $10,000 or so to do that. That's fine. If you want to upgrade, I'll help you.
You said the word nice too many times, and I'm still not flying 15 hours. Hey, look, when we come back, we're sitting here with special guest Stephanie Ivey, an experienced traveler and a travel agent, Joanne Guilford. When we come back, we're going to talk a whole lot more about this. But, hey, think about culture for a minute. We're going to take a break for a quick second. We're going to think about culture. right after we talk about Rebrand Her. See y'all in just a bit.
Wake up, everybody, no more sleeping in bed. No more back to thinking, time for thinking ahead. The world has changed so very much from what it used to be. There's so much hatred, war and poverty. Oh, oh,
epitome of strength.
It's more than just a podcast. It's a movement.
Okay, welcome back. My that took a little longer than I expected to. Kim, what you got for you know, it don't matter because she just came up with what she's gonna talk about anyway. So, got 2 minutes. So Kim, what you got for us?
So y'all bear with me, okay? Bear with me because I changed my mind here at the last minute because I figured that someone has passed away recently that we haven't really highlighted on Rebrand Her. And I feel like she's really Rebrand Her worthy. And I'm talking about Betty Marion White Ludden, also known as Betty White. I almost said Barry White. So Betty White was born January 17th, 1922. And she was an American actress and a comedian. And of course, she was a pioneer of early television. She appeared on so many different television shows. We know, of course, The Golden Girls is one of my favorite shows of all times besides The Jeffersons. So she was a pioneer of early television. She was also on the Mary Tyler Moore Show. She was on The Match Game. She was on Password. She also won a Daytime Emmy Award for Outstanding Game Show Host for the show Just Men in 1983. She was on The Bold and the Beautiful. But not only that, you know, Betty was a pioneer because she stood up for racial inequality in her own way, of course. There was a dancer by the name of Arthur Duncan that was to appear on her talk show in 1954. And NBC was the network that it aired on. And they told her that she could not have him on her show because he was Black. He was African-American. And so Betty stood up for what was right in that moment and said that if he can't come on, then there will no longer be a show, you know? So Arthur ended up being on her show and Betty was just all about equality, just period. For animals, for African-Americans, people of all walks of life. So I appreciate Betty White's life. I just pray that I last as long as half is what she did, you know. And she would have hit her 100th birthday on January 17th. But she didn't quite make it. She passed away from this cruel world on December 31st. So kudos to Betty White. Betty White, we love you for eternity. Recently, there was a Betty White challenge for animal activists. They raised money in one day, and they raised over $70,000 for animals and to get the treatment that they needed, like animals who needed surgery and different things and needed saving. So Betty White is definitely one that will go down in the books for sure. So
What happened to Brass?
Thank you very much for that, Kim. All right, listen, y'all. Black History Month will be here in just a few short weeks, and as quickly as it'll come, it'll be gone. Here at Rebranders, we'll celebrate our Black History all 28 days, and join us Wednesday at 7:30 p.m. as we do our part to empower, promote, enrich, and remember our history and our people. However, there is a word that has plagued the Black community since the release of our enslaved ancestors. Many say it's a term of endearment or a word that is just misunderstood. Others say it's a debilitating word that's so degrading that the very sound of it changes the way people think and act. Join us next week as we talk about That was pretty sweet, right?
It was. Good job.
Thank you very
much. Okay. Thank you.
Hey, look, I'm going to show a quick clip, and we're going to talk about this. We're going to break away from travel for a minute, Joanne, and we're going to see exactly how you all feel about this topic here.
So why did he need a Black director? Could a white director not have...
It's not color. It's culture.
Explain the difference, because I think we're
Steven Spielberg right did Schindler's List. Mm-hmm. Martin Scorsese did Goodfellas, right? Steven Spielberg could direct Goodfellas. Martin Scorsese probably could have done a good job with Schindler's List, but they're cultural differences. I know, you know, we all know what it is when a hot comb hits your hair on a Sunday morning, mm-hmm. what it smells like. Huh? That's a cultural difference. Not just the color difference. So it's the culture.
So this is going to be a show one of these days. I'm thinking cultural difference, Stephanie. Now, are we losing our culture? What do you think about that? Us as Black people. Now, I'm thinking what Denzel just said about the hot comb. Eventually, what if you don't have that anymore? As time goes on, you get less and less hot comb. You get less and less struggle. You get less and less of these things. So will that kill the culture of Black people? Real quick before you answer that. I had my next door neighbor, and I probably shouldn't have said that because if he's watching, he said to me that he think that there should be just one culture, and that's the American culture. And I said, whose culture is that? You know, whose culture would that be? Would that be a Black culture, a white culture? Because it's got to be somebody's. Anyway, Stephanie, what do you think?
I feel like the culture is just changing. A lot of the stuff that we considered the culture when we were younger, it is kind of dying out, the hot combs and the, you know, things like that. But we still have culture. It's just evolving.
Eric?
I really like the topic that he brought up, culture versus color, because a lot of times people will mistake, in my opinion, color for culture. Like, I'm Black, and some people was like Ace is a big thing in second pants. They associate that with Blacks, not necessarily just Black culture. To me, that's not culture. That's somebody's personal experience, or personal appearance, right? But they attach it to Black people. I don't want that to be associated to culture, because that could be associated with negativity, right? So, yeah, the hot comb, I think it is dying out, that kind of stuff out there. But we do have to, I think, for us to have a Black culture experience, then we have to identify what those things are inside the Black culture, because I don't think we have an idea what those things are anymore, because it is such an involvement going on in the world right now. Because a lot of black people grew up poor. You know, not a lot of middle income black people, not some rich black people. So our culture, our color part is differentiating every time the income goes up as well. So our experience is not going to be the same. So I'll be glad to have a conversation about what black culture or culture looks like in America today, eventually.
Well, Joanne, both of y'all, Stephanie and Eric, y'all see this shine on my hair right here? This is a pressing comb.
Okay.
This is a pressing comb. Shout out to Miss Janice who does my hair.
Hey, Kim, you over 40 right now, though. We got some 20-year-olds listening right now. No, about that.
Eric, don't be
my bad. I'm sorry. My bad. Hey,
Kim, but no, I mean, you're right, you know, and I think that our culture, we do have culture vultures. We have people who like to adopt our culture because they like the way it looks, you know, and they don't know really, it's not always how it looks, it's how it feels as well. So my thing is, yes, it has changed and it is ever so changing because we're doing different things, you know, we're evolving as a people. So of course, you know, the things that were regular in the black household is no longer regular, like the pressing comb, you know, she was a gem that I found her that she still used one. So, yeah, that's what I think. But I don't think it's dying out. I think we're just, you know, evolving. That's what I think.
So Joanne,
some things are gonna, like I still have 50 Walmart and Kroger bags under my kitchen sink.
Oh, sorry.
You're not gonna go.
I had to turn off my music. So I was, you know, Anthony and Kimberly, you know, we grew up in the same neighborhood, same side of town. So we all knew, and I actually had this conversation with a coworker not too long ago, and we all grew up together. It was a black. Everybody on our street, same color and everything. And we knew each other. We all rode the same bus. And then I told her, you know, when I moved, I was like, my neighborhood does not look like my childhood neighborhood. It's very integrated. Mm-hmm. And so I was just kind of expressing that my kids are kind of missing out on some of the things I got to experience just by being around people who look like me. Mm-hmm. And of course, she threw it out, you know, it's like, well, whose fault is that? I'm like, well, I wasn't looking for blame. I was just making a statement of what my children's growing up, their experience is going to be different.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, I think that's the importance of diversity. I mean, it's okay to diversify. It's okay to have people living in the same neighborhood, but culture itself is okay also. I'm very comfortable from where the struggles that I grew up with. You know, when you're poor, if you're poor and you're black, you have a certain thing that you do, dishwashing liquid in the tubs. Everybody around the country knows that's how you create bubble bath, you know, and to me, that's part of the culture. You know, everybody didn't do that. And so that's what brings us together as a culture, as a race, as a people. And then, you know, but we can still diversify because rich folk didn't do it. Don't mean that, you know, it should be accepted. I just, that's a conversation that we should definitely have someday. Ace, what you think?
As far as the culture, yeah, I think we're evolving. I do.
Let me say this before you answer, man. You are one good ventriloquist. My God,
am I froze up?
I told you, man. You stuck.
Well, look here. That's what's wrong with our culture. You pay attention to the message and not the messenger. Don't worry about the message. You pay attention to the message.
Okay.
That's what y'all need to be focused on. I just think we need to, you know, we need to always make sure that we pay homage. It's nothing wrong with moving forward, but let's not forget, you know, CJ Walker didn't steal that recipe just for y'all to, you know, forget about it. So I don't mind our culture being spread around. I don't mind other cultures using our culture. It's just, I don't like when credit is not given where credit is due. Mm-hmm. Like, you know, every time you bring up some braids and stuff, you know, don't show me Bo Derek, whatever her name is. Every time you bring up some braids and stuff like that, you know, let's pay on where did she get the idea from, you know, and things like that. So it's good to evolve. And I don't think we're losing. I take it back. I do think with the younger generation, we are losing some of the culture because, it's like a total disconnect as far as they really don't care about what you went through and the meaning behind it. You know, I don't think they have that. I don't think they grew up under grandma like we did, whether you had parents or not. You know, the old folks in the neighborhood. I remember we used to walk to school. And old man Pruitt used to stop us and just tell us a story for no reason. We'd be late for school listening to old man Pruitt and stuff like that. I think that's one of the things that we don't have today. And Joanne, I think this kind of stems from what you said as far as the way the communities look now.
Absolutely. And ironically, Stephanie's grandmother lived a house down from my grandmother.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, that's not
Stephanie. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And also, when we do have that conversation, it makes sure we diversify the panel too. I want to make sure the people, like you said, that brought that conversation up about the one culture, I'd be curious to hear a perspective behind that too. You know, I'm thinking now that could be a blended culture, but what does that look like? You know what I mean? So I would love to hear perspective around what they meant when they said one culture personally too. So,
all right, before we go to Ace's place, we were forced to integrate. This is Ima Weidman, by the way. We were forced to integrate even if we wanted to keep culture together because of, is that a real name? I don't want to insult
her. Yes, that's her name. That's Ima. Mm-hmm.
I'm a wide man. Mm-hmm. We were forced to integrate even if we wanted to keep culture together because of inequalities and choices of education, housing, and opportunities. I love it. I love it, Ima. That's a great one. And I apologize for the cracking of the name. Anyway, we'll be back in just a little bit with Ace's Place.
Want to bring that curb appeal back to your home or business? Let us help you. Call Ace Power Washer at 469-337-4080 or email us at powerwashingace3@gmail.com. Whether it's sidewalks, driveways, house or building washing, we'll take care of it. Call or email today for your free quote. We'll see you soon.
Deep down, I don't think any of us thought that we would see a conviction, even though it was on video. What's funny about it is, Herschel does exactly what the slave masters used to do back in the day. He used the Bible to get his point across.
Oh, man. Stop letting TV raise the kids. Stop letting sports be the only way out, things like that.
Ace's Place. All right, I'm gonna have to pay for that one because you got the watermark on it. All right,
am I still stuck?
Yeah.
Man,
I don't know what's going on. I used to have a magnificent. You know what? It's rather windy in my neck of the woods. That could have something to do with the situation. Not sure. Well, everybody meditate on the words coming from my mouth and not the movement of my face.
You look serious, though. That's good, though. You look real serious.
Okay. So, basically, on Ace's Place, I just want to kind of give a brief PSA. Black folks, let's stop putting all our start following the word of God and stop following the man of God.
Amen.
We got so much stupid stuff going on now. Learn the Bible for yourself and then look at your pastor as a teacher, as a guide, as a professor of the word and things like that. Your pastor's not God. Your pastor's not Jesus at all. He's a steward. He's a shepherd of the word. Saying this in light of just, I'm not sure if y'all saw the what was going on with Pastor Todd out in Oklahoma. Any of y'all you heard about that? Yeah. So basically, you know, he was giving an example of one of the stories from the Bible where Jesus healed the blind man. But so he had, I think it turned out to be his brother or his brother-in-law on stage, and he actually, in a demonstration during church, he actually hot spit into his hand and rubbed the spit on the man's eyes, face, like Jesus did in the Bible. Now, I tell you what, I ain't saying I'd drag a pastor, but I'm just saying a pastor would have got drugged. It's no way in hell you can tell me that you are that stupid that you're going to sit on stage and allow this pastor to demonstrate this.
Was he blind?
No, he wasn't blind. He probably was blind after the COVID and everything got all in his pupils and everything. But But you know, we just do, as a culture, we do so much silly stuff, you know, and we're controlled through the church a lot of times. And I think a lot of it is because we rely on the pastor to tell us what to do and things like that. Most of us don't know the word for ourselves. You know, when it comes to politics, the politicians, they come to the church. You know, just anything we have to do with the Black community, they come to the church and try to work through the church. So I'm just saying, we got to start thinking for ourselves. We got to start reading the word for ourselves, knowing the word for ourselves, things like that. You know, people sending money to, what's his name? Kearney Thomas, the screaming pastor that be on BET, used to be on BET late at night, you know, screaming to the top of his lungs, you know, and throwing that cloth out of the TV, or, you know, people look at the commercials, people lying, talking about they got a prayer cloth and some blessed spring water, and they got a $57,000 check the next week and stuff like that. It's time as a one thing, like we're talking about culture, it's time as a culture, some things we have to get around. Some things we have to, you know, we have to get over. But this Pastor Todd thing kind of took it over the edge. It was just amazing to me, that demonstration that happened. And that's it. I just want to talk to my folks for a minute.
Aces place. All right, so Stefani, Joanne, the two travelers with experience on this show, tell us, what's some of the most important things we should know about traveling?
One important thing is to make sure you're traveling with the right people. You cannot travel with everybody, and picking the wrong travel group can ruin the entire trip.
Been there, done that.
So yeah, knowing your people, finding somebody who has the same travel philosophy as you, like my group of girls, like we travel well, we kind of believe in the same things. Like, hey, we all paid for this trip. Everybody needs to get out of it what they want. If you want to go to the museum and nobody else does, go. Don't try to drag me with you. and don't not go because we don't. And my friend, she loves the museum. She's like, hey, I'm about to go to the museum. I'll catch up with y'all later. So I love that nobody feels like the whole group has to stick together or anything like that. So yeah, your travel group can make or break the entire trip. So that's important.
Joanne?
From my standpoint, I think for an agent, important things to kind of know is, and this is just some of the things that I've come across, is just your passport, have that, work on that, have that in at a time. If you're going to travel internationally, already have your passport process or already have it in hand. Because there are delays, you may be able to get expedited, but you know, or it might take you 3 weeks, it might take you 6 weeks, you just don't know. So it's best to go ahead and have your passport. Also make sure that you have, you know, where your passport matches your ID, and your birth certificate, all that your identifying documents match. Also, if you have any legal obligations, because I get asked this sometimes, if you're on probation or parole, I mean, people ask, can I leave the country? I'm like, I'm not your probation officer. I don't know where you can and can't go, but you need to get that cleared. That's not part of my job description. Just know your destination, your status, you know, and whether you, just your budget, what are you willing to spend and what can you afford?
Well, I'm glad you said that. Next question we have, of course, is the budget. Black people are traveling more now than I've seen ever before. When I was a kid, I'm like, Kim, we never traveled. Not by airplane, we didn't. What we did is we didn't go anywhere now that I think about it. Not what you would consider a vacation. So, you know, what's the biggest setback for black people traveling? Is it money or is it fear? Because, you know, a lot of black people are still afraid to get on an airplane and go, especially those who've never done it once. So what's the biggest setback, do y'all think? And I'm just throwing that to everybody.
I think fear right now, a lot of things I think is everybody's, you know, a lot of people are afraid of COVID, the restrictions. A lot of people don't want to get vaccinated. A lot of people don't want to wear masks. They don't want to get tested. So a lot of things, and I'll reach out to clients or former client, or not former, but past clients, and ask if they're ready for their next trip. They'll say, well, I want to wait till COVID dies down or COVID goes away. I don't know if that's, you know, a reality for us, but I respect it. But, you know, that's, you know, I just keep it moving. Mm-hmm. But those are factors.
Joanne, I want to ask your professional opinion. Mm-hmm. Like, would you cruise in the next couple of weeks? Because I've been hearing different things, like, you know, people are being quarantined on the cruise ship. You're not able to get off at the destinations and go on different excursions and everything with the cruises right now since COVID has been a little kicked up. What would you advise someone who has a trip that is scheduled and booked in the next couple of weeks? What would you advise?
First thing I would advise, and what I do is I always book with travel insurance. I never book. I don't book any trips without travel protection or travel insurance, whether it's for credit or to get a refund. It's a bigger hassle to try to get your money back if you don't have some kind of protection. As far as the cruises and the port, it just depends on the port and what their numbers are looking like. I've had fellow agents tell me they'll be out to sea and the policy has changed. Like for the Bahamas, for example, they say they were in the middle of the, you know, before they got to the Bahamas said, okay, you gotta be vaccinated or whatever, their policies change. So if you're comfortable with going to the, in my opinion, if you're comfortable going to the store and going to work, you know, then, you know, and you want to travel, just use the same precautions, hygiene, sanitize, and just be mindful and wear your mask if you're comfortable with that.
Okay.
So Ace, there are different types of traveling, right? You got road trips, cruises, a plane trip. What else?
Skateboard?
Oh man, we practiced this. We practiced this. You forgot the punchline.
Yeah,
Did you take more than two steps?
I must have dozed off.
If you take more than two steps in basketball, never mind. Hey, look.
I bet that corny joke. I can't put that on.
All right, we got rebrand what coming up in just a little bit. And Stephanie and they're going to tell us exactly what the best travel locations and, you know, if they travel alone, if they like doing those things. Kim, tell me, what's some important things about traveling with you? I know you travel with the girls quite a bit.
Yes, I do. And like Stephanie said, I'm going to piggyback off of what she said. It is very important who you travel with. Because like she said, it can ruin a whole trip. So I'm real selective on that, you know, because if there's something I want to do, I just do it, you know. So, and I think that's important. I think also, you know, it's important to get a little, to learn a little bit of something everywhere you go, because I might not go back to that destination. I might not visit that city again, even though I had a good time, you know, I still might not ever go back. But I still like to learn something everywhere that I go, be it a museum, be it a landmark, or be it somewhere downtown. I like to visit downtowns and see what everybody's downtown looks like. There's usually some history in a downtown. So, but those are important to me, for sure.
All right, rebrand what coming up in just a bit.
It means you're going to stop segregating. Integration means like you're mixing a cake. Till you mix it, you got the stuff, but you haven't put it together yet. And even when you put it together, you got to put it in the oven and bake it. And bake it at a certain temp, because that dough and that stuff haven't cooked yet. That means when you integrate, you got to go in there between all the strife. Wake up, everybody, no more sleeping in bed.
Definitely the foundation of for everything, because if you don't have love or a passion for something, you're not going to fight towards it. My kids are very young still at this point, 4 and 2. However, teaching them how to respect themselves, respecting each other. Rebrandus' mission is basically to help empower Black people to envision ourselves as better people.
Ladies and gentlemen, you're watching rebrandUS. I'm your host, Anthony Goodson. Coming up in just a bit, we got Eric Russell with Rebrand What. Got Stefani, Ivey, and Joanne Guilford on tonight. Hey, Stefani, that was and Joanne. I'm sure y'all know Miss Dorothy Jo Thomas. If you don't, she used to teach with your grandmother, Stefani, and of course, the rest of us know. Anyway, Eric, what you got for us today?
I got two things, but real brief though. Since we're talking about traveling with a purpose. You know, I like to go from come from a mental health standpoint. Another purpose for traveling is self-care. You know, a lot of people do that just to get away from their environment and to recharge physically, mentally, spiritually, emotionally. You know, I don't think about this as we were talking though. Even though growing up, a lot of people who didn't have money didn't go many places. You can go simply to the lake. Let's say you live in DFW, you live in Garland, you can go to Lake Louisville. Get out of Garland, go to Louisville, go to Lake Louisville. You can Louisville the same way, go to Lake Red Hub in Garland. And just go and get out in a regular environment and just go look at the lake and just kind of revamp yourself a little bit. Look at the water cones mean. So I love going to the lake. I love going, oceans is cool too. I love, you know, I'm not getting out in the ocean water personally to swim or anything to that nature, but I love water in general. So just thinking about that, from a mental health standpoint, self-care is very, very important, and traveling is definitely a big, big piece of that. So please, if you love to travel, even consider going, you know, different parts of the city, different parts of your geographical area. But I definitely encourage anybody and everybody who can definitely to go different states and outside of the country as well. I also want to speak real quick about something I just saw. If you guys haven't heard about the voting rights bill that's happening right now, I think the Republicans just blocked it in the Senate from the Democrats. So I'm not going to go into what it's about, but I am going to give everybody some homework, though. I want everybody to go look up what the voting bill rights is if you don't know what it is. It's something that rebrandUS was talking about a year ago, but it's something that's come back up, and it's something that we definitely need to keep on our radar in regards to what our rights are as voters. And that's a big deal right now. As you know, with Trump lost last election, a lot of people were upset. And so they're trying to do different things to block some people voting rights, things like that. So anyway, go check the voting rights out and then try to follow this story pretty closely because it's going to affect a lot of people. So,
absolutely good point. I love that one, Eric. Travel with a purpose. That's what we're talking about today. Stefani Ivey. All right, Stefani, you travel a lot. And, Joanne, you I'm sure book a lot and travel a lot yourself. You travel so much. Do you guys have a bucket list?
I do. Number one on my bucket list is the Giraffe Manor in Nairobi, Kenya. It's the little like bed and breakfast. It's this really small little bed and breakfast where the giraffes are just outside. Every morning they stick their heads in the windows and you can like feed them through the windows. Like that's number one on my bucket list. Yes. Listen,
you travel so much. You starting to do, we got any white people listening? Gotta do white people stuff. Look here. I just don't want to get mugged when I go to New York City. Hey, you running with the giraffes.
That's another reason why you got to travel is because once you get yourself out of your comfort zone, you'll find that you like I like doing things that they'd be like, black people don't do that. I want to do that. Like, why do white people get to have all the adventure and fun? Like, I want to have some fun.
Right. That's an adventure. And then it's in Kenya, yeah. too.
Yeah, so you get to experience, right, this is in Africa, like.
Mm-hmm. So, Stephanie, on our promo of you a moment ago, we see you skydiving. That's, I mean, you, it's more than just travel, it's an adventure for you, right?
Yeah, I'm an adrenaline junkie a little bit. So, yeah, I've been skydiving a few times and skiing. When I don't know how to ski, I'm like, I'll figure it out. Just get
that's funny bono
like,
that.
Like, I should have learned how to stop before I got... got up here. But yeah, I like a good adventure.
Good adventure. Okay, so Joanne, what's on your bucket list?
My bucket list, a couple years ago, after my mom died, one of the things I decided is I don't want to be, because my birthday's in the summer, I said I don't want to be home on my birthday. So every year, at least I want to go somewhere. So I have several things that I have on my list, going to Hawaii and Costa Rica. That's this year. And Christmas time, we're probably going to go to Colorado. We've been to Breckenridge. That was a good trip.
Yeah.
We were able to, and you made a comment about white people stuff. Well, we went to Colorado. We did dog sledding. We rode dog sleds. We were tubing and snowmobile, and that was pretty cool. And when my husband got back to work and he was showing some of his friends, that's what something they said. That's the white people stuff. But I'm like, anybody can do it. And it was great. And that was what I wanted to expose my kids to, is just different things. We don't always have to go to a beach. You know, I'm not a fan of the cold, but I really enjoyed it. And next year, looking at a couple other options, probably going to Greece. So that's off on my radar.
You know, if what you see is all you see, you don't see all that there is. I'm just kidding about the white people stuff. But hey, Stephanie talking about sleeping with giraffes and stuff.
My niece, she just got back from Iceland, and I thought that was really, really cool. She was gone for a whole course of a little over a week, I think. And she went alone. I mean, you know, she went with a travel group.
Man,
she didn't go with any of her friends, so she was a very avid traveler. And kudos to her. You know, she doesn't have any kids, and she's tall and light skinned like Stephanie. So
traveling solo is a whole nother, like, that is you big time now, because you traveling anyways is getting you out of your comfort zone. But when you are by yourself, you have to just it's kind of terrifying, but it's rewarding as well.
Yeah, after I saw the movie Hostel, there won't be no traveling at all.
Well, I asked my niece about it, and I told her, I said, you know, you just don't seem like you would have the type of personality to where you would travel with a travel group, somebody that you've never even met before. And she said, you know, she was like, well, Aunt Kim, it takes me out of my comfort zone, you know? It forces me to have to be social and meet other people, because if I don't, you know, I'm just sitting over here by myself.
You know? Or when you're with your friends, a lot of times your group just talks amongst your group. You don't meet anybody else outside of your group, when the people is the best part about traveling. The people that you can meet, the connections you can make with them. I have some lifelong friendships from people that I've met around the world, and experiences that have come from that. Like the ski trip I just came from, that was my third year. I get paid to go there. Like, I don't pay. They pay me to go. And that's somebody that I met while camping. He was like, hey, you should come, you know. And I'm like, okay. So from that one camping trip, I get to go skiing for free every year.
That's wild. That's deep.
I met a guy in Thailand. And after that trip, he's like, hey, you and your friends, y'all should come to Martha's Vineyard with me and my friends, you know. Y'all ain't got to pay for nothing. Just come have a good time with us. Okay, we'll be there. We were on our way. And then he was on the board of directors for NAACP. So he's like, hey, you want to go to the Image Awards? Like, y'all can get in. We'll get you into the after party. So it's like the people that you meet while you're traveling could just open so many other doors. And that's the best part. So when you're by yourself, you're more likely to meet other people.
Man. That's good. So Kayleen says, who are strangers are the best trips? the best trips. You know what? I've traveled by myself a couple times, but typically it's for work purposes. But I agree with you. I don't know who said it, Stephanie or Joanne, one of you. I love to meet people when I'm on these trips. Mm-hmm. Like, you see people that have a completely different, I mean, because when you go on a trip and you travel, nothing really matters. It's just the conversation that matters. I don't care how much money you make, or I don't care what your race is. Met a guy in New York City. He goes quite often. I think he was from Ohio or something. But what he likes to do is put his backpack on and walk from, I think, Times Square, and he walked through Brooklyn and Coney Island. I mean, it's a long, long trip if y'all been there before. You can't just walk it in a day. But he does things like that. But he was such an interesting young fella. So anyway, I like to meet the people. That's huge. Ooh. All right, Ace, we got something for you here in just a little bit.
Hey, yo, Ace, who do we have on the show next week?
I'm discussing the topics that have to deal with the black family. You know the food or the drink is good when the person says squalor instead of swallow. We're going to have an interview with librarians with Tourette syndrome. And the name of the show is going to be titled Breaking the Rules. And we will have their mics muted most of the time. Married couples that swing at the playground, are they confused or just risk takers? Giggity giggity. We'll see how that goes. You know,
catch Adrian, the Ace Stinson, and the rest of the Rebrandus crew live Wednesdays at 7:30 p.m. Central on YouTube and Instagram at Rebrandus Podcast, Facebook at Rebrandus, or rebrandus.org.
I work too hard. Look, I work too hard for this stuff, man.
Yo, Ace,
what's going on?
Oh, do I have to say it?
You gotta ask me.
Oh, yeah. Hey, so we got a show next week.
Yeah. Well, look, I found us a great sponsor for next week's show. You know, I've been trying to get more, you know, different diverse type of sponsors here and there. So we actually have a medical sponsor for next week's show. It's the Tonya Harding Knee Replacement Center. They're gonna get us going. And they're gonna knock it out.
Their motto is sticks and stones, maybe.
Yeah, that's it.
Sticks and stones. It's gonna be a hot show next week. All right, any exhortations, Stephanie and Joanne? Call to action. That's a big word. I just learned it this week myself. Any call to action? What should we?
Well, let Joanne go first so I can use some context clues.
I just learned it myself. I actually was watching something. They said, what's the call to action? I said, oh, what's a good synonym for that? And exhortation was one. That was one that I didn't think Ace was going to actually know. So
I appreciate you, brother.
Yeah, right on. Joanne, give us some last words about traveling.
When you're out traveling, just the same precaution you would take if you were staying local. Just practice good hygiene. Be safe. Be aware of your surroundings. Just enjoy yourself and make good memories. And if you looking for an agent to take care of you and your travel needs, then reach out to Jack Vacations and I'll do that for you. Beautiful. And thank you all for having me on today.
Oh yeah. And hey, stay on after the show, y'all, if y'all can. We like to talk to you for a quick minute. And we'll also put your flyers and stuff up on Rebrandus, and we'll be sure to share those. Stephanie, exhortations.
I would say just get out there and go. Like, just book that first one. Like Ace said, he didn't really travel much, but now that he's gone, like, now he's a believer. So don't let fear stop you from going. Don't let other people's experiences of places stop you from going somewhere, because people like, oh, I hate, yeah, I don't like Vegas personally. I don't like Vegas, but I still want everybody to go experience it for themselves. Just because somebody else doesn't like something doesn't mean you're not going to like it. Mm-hmm. So go experience everything for yourself. Step outside of your comfort zone. Try different foods. Talk to the locals. And yeah, just make some lasting memories.
All right, Eric, Kim, Ace, y'all got anything?
I'm like Stephanie. Just go for it. If you can afford it and you can do it comfortably, why not? I mean, if you never get out and see some things, you'll never learn something new. You'll never meet new people. So I think it's a great thing. Also, I want to add a little snippet. Y'all bundle up. It's going to get in the 20s tonight or the 30s. It's supposed to be like 27 when we wake up in the morning. So
unless they're traveling up. And they're not here.
Yes, unless you're traveling and they're not here. Yeah, that's, you know, so. But just like, I'm like Stephanie, just go for it. Just go.
But budget now. Have your money right now. Don't get out there and can't do anything. Right. You spend all your money on the flight and the hotel and then you can't do
Absolutely. Well, hey, normally we play our outro. Today we're gonna play a quick little video. Thank y'all for watching this show. Be sure to share it. You can still share it and allow people to watch. Next week we have a great show. We got Lon Boyce, Kevin Woodson. They both credentialed. They're very intelligent individuals. The name of our show, Ace?
Goodson. Anthony Goodson.
Not at all. Hey, we'll see y'all next week.
Yeah, man, that hunky muffin mess my whole way. We got the money cool upside down his head, you know.
Hey, home, I can dig it. No, he ain't gonna lay no more big rap up on you, man.
I say, hey, Sky. Subba say I won't sing. Pray to Jay, I did the same old, same old.
Mac yourself a pro slick. The gray matter back, lot performers down. I take TCB in, man.
Hey, you know what they say. See a broad to get that booty act. Leg her down and smack him, yak him. Oh, God. You know?
Can I get you something?
It's your mofo. Put a leg into the bone. Tight, man.
I'm sorry. I don't understand.
Cuddy say can't hang.
Oh, stewardess. I speak jive.
Oh, good.
He said that he's in great pain and he wants to know if you can help him.
All right. Would you tell him to just relax and I'll be back as soon as I can with some medicine.
Just hang loose, blood. She's gonna catch up on the rebound on the med side.
What it is, big mama. My mama raised no dummies. I duck a rap.
Cut me some slack, Jack.
Say, cut it.
Chump don't wanna help. Chump don't get there.